I want to talk about antibiotics and the way we are losing them. Antibiotics is one of the greatest discoveries of science. I have been prescribing these drugs for 15 years working in a university hospital, and I want to continue prescribing these drugs because they save lives. Recently, I'm becoming jealous of other specialties, rheumatology, oncology, cardiology, because they have new, more effective drugs that really improve patient outcomes. In contrary, I'm running out of drugs. Today, I prescribed to the patient in intensive care unit colistin, drug that was introduced in 1955 and soon discarded because of toxic side effects. Now, this drug is back because it's the only drug that we can use for treatment of patients infected with a particular resistant pathogen. Antibiotics is one of the greatest discoveries of science. Antibiotics are poisons that act on a cell wall of bacteria, destroying them. We have hundreds of poisons available. Some of them we are able to use in medicine. Thanks to antibiotics, billions of lives have been saved. We are able to treat deadly infectious diseases we were never able to treat before. Modern medicine is based on antibiotics. Not only infectious diseases treatment, but also prosthetic surgery, transplantation, cancer chemotherapy is dependent on antibiotics because patients receive prophylaxis. So where the resistance came from? Some patients tell that they are becoming resistant to antibiotic. Please prescribe me more potent one. It's not true. Patients are not resistant to antibiotics. Bacteria are. The problem with bacteria that they are so many and multiplying in tremendous speed. During this multiplication, genetic mutations occur that makes some of them resistant to antibiotics. If we apply antibiotic to these colonies of billions of bacteria, then some of them survive, the resistant ones. And that makes difference for the patient. If patients get admitted to hospital, they receive first-line, guideline-based treatment with so-called narrow-spectrum antibiotic. But in this case, if patient is infected with resistant bacteria, they don't get better, they get worse. It takes 2-3 days to understand that your treatment is not effective. So you have to prescribe another antibiotic, so-called wide-spectrum antibiotic. Next time, physician is scared and starts treatment with so-called wide-spectrum antibiotic. But this antibiotic creates more selection pressure, and we end up with more resistant bacteria populations. So it is a problem. It is the big innovation on reverse. It is like your mobile phones would be switched off, or internet, or even electricity. This is what it is for a medical community. So what are the solutions? Some may say, science will save us. Okay, that's correct. There's several reports every month showing us success of science in finding new antimicrobial agents. Nevertheless, only some of them make to the markets. The new drug pipeline is very short. There are not that many drugs appearing in the market. It is because pharmaceutical industry needs to invest huge amount of money to run the clinical trials. And why should they invest in drugs that will be used for 3-5 day courses and eventually will expire due to resistance? They would rather invest in chronic disease, lifestyle, and aging. So we cannot expect many drugs soon. Another approach is to use vaccines. Vaccines are very important because they're better than antibiotics. But production of vaccines is even slower and more difficult and more expensive. We can't expect many vaccines. We are facing many bacteria. What we do in hospitals, we try to isolate the patients with resistant bacteria. We employ stringent infection control measures, not prevent spread from one patient to another. That works on a small scale. It can't be done in outpatient setting. We have new equipment that makes us more capable of detecting pathogens within few hours, even the resistance genes. Anyway, that is expensive. If you are in outpatient setting, you still have to bring sample to the laboratory. So what can we do? Science will definitely save us on the long run. I'm pretty sure about that. But what we can do now, within the next 5-10 years, we know that countries that use less antibiotics have lower resistance rates. It is interesting that in European Union, consumption of antibiotics per capita is quite different. You can see 2-3-4 difference between different countries. What is an explanation? Nobody knows. It clearly has something to do with human behavior. Why should Belgium and Netherlands' consumption differ 2 times? Why should North do much better than South? Apparently, some physicians in low-use countries are more happy not to prescribe an antibiotic. And physicians and patients in some countries are happy not to take antibiotic. This is very interesting to understand the behavioral difference between countries, between cultures, because we have to reduce antibiotic use dramatically. This is the only thing we can do in the next 5-10 years. We decided to study the behavior of Latvian family physicians. We recorded antibiotic prescriptions in 1 week in a large number of family physicians. The results were quite surprising. Most of the antibiotics were prescribed to children younger than 10 years, followed by teenagers. Altogether, children contributed to 65% of outpatient antibiotic use. The conditions treated were mainly bronchitis and sore throat. It is clearly not infections caused by bacteria. Maybe 1 in 10 can be bacterial infection, particularly in children. And that can be easily detected by good clinical judgment and simple tests. So, what is the problem? Why family physicians prescribe so many antibiotics to Latvian children? Latvia, as you saw in a previous slide, is a low antibiotic use country. So it looks like it's our problem treating children. It's a behavior. It's clearly we need behavioral research to understand this. Nobody wants to harm children. But this culture of being on the safe side, just in case something happens, take it. Antibiotics won't harm you anyway. Take it for 3 days, 5 days. That's fine. That is the culture we all are familiar here. The same with surgeons in our hospital. They tend to prolong surgical prophylaxis with antibiotics for 2-3 days longer than it's required. There's no scientific evidence for that. When I tell them that, they look at me like I want them to drive on the opposite side of the road. Because it's their culture, it's their behavior and habit. They have been doing this for decades. Their teachers were doing this. So it's very difficult to change behavior. I'm not good in changing behaviors. I'm just infectious diseases doctor. Probably we should look for public relations and marketing specialists that are able to sell people things they never need. So it's really, we have to look wider on this problem. So some examples. This is a report. The British superbug outbreak could kill 80,000 people. Terrible news. Full-scale alarm, isn't it? What can we do? I, as infectious diseases specialist, say, let's use less antibiotics. Is this the good answer? That answers the fears and safety of people? No. Another approach is public campaigns are focusing on the issue that you shouldn't be treating viral infections with antibiotics. It's a negative message. But people ask, but what if it is bacterial infection? How can you tell? Okay, this is clear to me, but how can you tell it's something, it's not bacterial? We have a problem here as well. We have to tell people something positive, that we can detect bacterial infection with simple tests and clinical judgments. Bacterial infections are extremely rare, and usually many patients get directly to hospital because they are obviously sick. So, we have an urgent need for intervention. We have scientific evidence to do something. We have to flip the switch from just in case something happens, let's give you a drug, it won't harm you, to something like, you should be using antibiotic just in some cases. If we would flip this switch, I would probably be able to use more antibiotics in our intensive care unit than this old-fashioned toxic drug that can really harm the patient. Thank you.